Matt Gaetz, for some reason, tweeted this. Tiffany Trump had a photo, so he tweeted to her, fire, heart, heart size, thumbs up, which I think we can all agree is the thirstiest tweet that has ever been sent in the history of Twitter. I don't know what that is. We're gonna have some responses, but Ida, he's a congressman. That's the president's daughter. And the only thing he didn't put is an eggplant. Like, all the rest of it's there.
You know what's funny is that Matt Gaetz is probably one of the most embarrassing members of our, you know, political. I mean, the way that he kind of tokenized Ernesto, and that was when he had that exchange that we talked about earlier with the congressman, and he pointed out that he was not racist because he had this, was it adopted son or whatever? But it just seems like he always works his way, works an angle to try to maintain some sort of relevance. And he feels like an actor or rapper or anybody whose career isn't going anymore well anymore. And now they just chime in on politics, and they realize like they get a little bit of action on that in that direction. But I just think it's embarrassing to watch him because I feel like he's so performative with his politics. And I think that it's an embarrassment. And you know, I'm in Florida right now and we want to wash. We need a wash.
Florida's been needing it for a while, actually. Okay, so let me give you a few more responses. Some of them more serious, some of them funnier. But Natalie Montalongo tweeted, below is a tweet from a sitting member of Congress. And here's a message for women everywhere. You are better than this man and you should run for Congress. Oh God, I would love to see someone take out Matt Gaetz. Let's make that happen. Molly Jong Fast tweeted, does this feel like a classy thing to be doing on the internet? To which the only reasonable answer is no, that's a very weird thing to be doing. Kate Smith asks to make DC boring again. The producers were nice enough to put in my tweet, yep, the thirst heard round the world.
I agree.
But I love, my favorite one was probably from Emma Vigeland, who quote retweeted it with a prescription for Matt Gaetz for horny be gone. But anyway, it's just so, he's a congressman and I get it. Like, you're supposed to pretend that the Trumps are the best and at everything in every way. And I guess, you know, like doing this thing with her is a way of making Trump like you better. Although bear in mind, it's a dangerous one because there's only one person that Trump is proven to be okay with sexualizing his daughters, and that's him. But anyway, yep. Matt Gaetz, you're at the best of times, you're a tool and you're ridiculous and embarrassing. But in this particular case, yep, the crime is clear. You committed the crime of being too horny. And so the sentence is equally clear, go to horny jail.
Yeah, my tweet is, does your daddy know his name yet? Remember, he didn't know his name.
God, American politics is a joke, Ida. How do you as a comedian joke about something as inherently ridiculous as this? It's already, the punchline is the setup.
Yeah, you don't. And that's why I stepped away from it, because you know, that's the thing that Donald Trump has semi-normalized in this country, is a behavior that is supposedly emboldened and direct and in your face. But it's just, it's like Fat Albert used to say, it's like school on Saturday, no class. And so I just sit here and I watch, and these are the people who make fun of or point out, you know, about people in lower from social economic backgrounds and call a ghetto and say that we, you know, we don't speak correctly or that our subjects and verbs don't agree. And here they are behaving this way publicly, and it's acceptable because they're white and they have money. And so I just look at it and say, look what he's brought to, as if we already didn't have enough problems politically in this country from what has been happening for hundreds of years. This now, and now you bring this. So this is the classic meme. This is how it started. This is where we are now. and the where we are now is just a big old trash can that's on fire. Yeah,
100%, 100%.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.